What's goody? We are back with another Q-Tip Fridays. Just got a fresh cut, as you can see. You know what I'm saying? Things looking kind of crispy. Weekend about to start, so gotta get ready for the weekend. You know? Not going anywhere, but it's just, you know, feeling good. You know, like, once you look good, you feel good. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what it comes down to. For real. So, this topic, or this week's topic, is about like my first entrepreneur inspiration, honestly. You know what I'm saying? Like, as far as the first person that I seen with my eyes, like, god damn, like, that person is really making it happen. Like, god damn, you know what? Maybe it is possible, you know? So it's a crazy story. So I was maybe around like 22, 23, I think, right? And then it was like around here, like in Pembroke Pines. And the dude, I'm not gonna say names and that kind of stuff, but the dude was, you know, I'm into cars, so like whenever I see a person with like with a certain car, like, you know, that attracts me, you know. So the dude had back then was like a white E92 M3, clean, super clean, fresh. That alone is like, what the fuck? Like, he's into, you know, like the cars that I'm into. Like, you know, like, I'm gonna actually, you know, peep that right there. Black dude too. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like, race is, they always say like race is not a thing, but at the same time, like, me being a black dude, like, me seeing another black dude doing it is gonna inspire me as a black dude, you know? It was like a white dude or a Spanish dude or like, you know, like some sort of other race, like, that's different. But at the same time, like, me being a black dude, like, that inspired me because That shows me that, goddamn, you know what? That's possible for me to actually obtain that as well. You know what I'm saying? So when I seen that, I was like, yo, like, he had a condo, like, he had he was probably like around 20, probably 26 at the time, like, doing his thing. You know what I'm saying? And I looked at that. You know, so what he used to do was like an MLM company. And I was like, yo, like, if he's doing this and making money, like, let me try it too, you know? So I seen that, you know, like, he was always on stage speaking to people, you know, like, really, really, like, a super extrovert type dude, you know? But, you know, that was never really, like my style to actually be that person that's always out there and just, you know, in front of people's faces and that kind of thing, like, back then, because I feel like I have a little bit of social anxiety at times, you know? So I didn't really understand how to actually go about that without having that certain kind of skill set. So I signed up for the company. I noticed that, you know, it was a lot of talking to people and that kind of thing, and I wasn't really feeling it, but at the same time I understood as to, like, you know, why he was at the level that he was, you know. And the crazy thing about those companies also is that it's always going to be a lot of mediocre people, but, you know, the people that excel in those companies, those people are pretty much people that, you know, took out that extra leap and, you know, got in a space that they were super uncomfortable with and then made it happen. You know what I'm saying? Like, the uncomfortability could have came from speaking to others, speaking on stage. So, like, once the person pretty much, you know, went past that, obviously a lot of success came beyond that point right there. So, like, that's where I wasn't really comfortable within myself at that point in time to even, you know, explore yet, you know? So eventually, you know, I pretty much figured that, like, it wasn't really for me. I ended up quitting the company. Then I pretty much started, you know, things that I'm into. But the entire time that he was within the company, like, I kept on, like, you know, being inspired by his moves, you know. He had a condo in Aventura. He had, you know, like, really, really doing his thing. And then eventually he traded in his M3 for an Audi R8. So these were things that I'm like, fuck, I could do this too. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know how I'm gonna do it, but I'm gonna do it in some kind of way, because it's a dude that is my color doing the same thing. You know, so like, that's gonna always be a thing, like, when it comes down to, like, if you're trying to actually be inspired by a person in some kind of way, just kind of like even see if something is real. I feel like that first person that you come across that's like as similar to you as possible, they're gonna be the most or the biggest inspiration to you based on them being a certain race, them being from a certain place, them being or coming from a certain situation. Something has to resonate with you to actually fully grasp, you know, that, you know, similarities. You know what I'm saying? So like once you could actually find that one person that you have the most in common with, a lot of times, like, that's all that you need to pretty much, you know, spark that fire to then, you know, want to work harder now, because now you see that, yo, like, damn, like, I can reach that because this person did it. You know, we came from the same place or like a similar place, or, you know, like, it can't be too far away. You know what I'm saying? And when I was in that company, actually, you know, I noticed a lot of things. You know, I noticed that, you know, there was a lot of fluff in certain cases and that kind of thing, but at the same time, I didn't care because even when there's a bunch of lies, there's some sort of truth as well. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's some sort of truth there as to why this person is doing what he's doing. Kind of like with trading now. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like people always say, you know, cars are rented and things are fake, blah, 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 right? But after all the fake stuff that people might think, right? You don't think that there's any type of realness there? Like, nothing's real? Nothing at all. Right? And think about it. If nothing was real, why can't anybody do it? Why can't anybody do it? If everything is fake, why can't anybody just get it if it's all fake? You know what I'm saying? So something had to be real there. So that's when I had to explore deeper when it comes to entrepreneurship and figure out, like, you know, like why are these certain people in the upper echelon of certain businesses compared to the mediocre people? Like, what are they doing different? And they're just trying to be more out there. They're trying to actually just be more of an extrovert and that kind of thing. Talk to people more. And that's what it comes down to. Like, after being in multiple businesses, like, there's always going to be in some sort of truth behind it. But you have to pretty much be willing to explore that certain truth. You know? And that was my first inspiration. Like, god damn, like, I'm seeing him in the local area. I'm like, yo, shit. So me just making that inspire me based off of the similarities, that's what it comes down to. Like, when it comes to entrepreneurship really sparks a person once they have or see another person that pretty much is very similar to you, and then from there you have more urgency to, like, just, like, want to actually, you know, figure things out and just, like, want to actually grow and, like, want to just, you know, learn more and that kind of thing. But you have to find that one person that you have that most in common with. And you don't even have to know them personally, because I never knew the person personally, but seeing him, I was like, yo, you know what? Okay, I fuck with it. All right, bet. All right, cool. You know, like, I started seeing things, and then those are the same things that I'm into as well. So, like, me seeing all that, that's where it started from. You know what I'm saying? So that's my rant. That's my first entrepreneur inspiration. And from that, now we here. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it comes down to. So thanks, everybody, for watching Q-Tip Fridays. And in the comments, tell me about your first entrepreneur inspiration. What inspired you to actually get on your shit to work harder to get to a better place in life? Put us out of comments. Like, share. But definitely, I want to hear your story as well. All right, so peace out. Next Friday.